Lucius Licinius Lucullus was the man to whom Sulla dedicated his memoirs before the dictator died. Lucullus was elected as Sulla's quaestor when the latter assumed command of the army during the Social War. Lucullus, the son of the Lucullus accused of embezzlement during Sicily's slave rebellion, continued serving as quaestor to Sulla for approximately 8 years. This resulted in the longest quaestorship in Roman history. And though Pompeius Magnus saw himself as Sulla's political heir, it was to Lucullus that Sulla left guardianship of his minor children, twins Faustus and Fausta from his marriage to Dalmatica, and the posthumously born Cornelia Postuma, from his widow, Valeria Messalla. Following Sulla's successful campaign against Mithridates, Lucullus returned to Rome with so much booty that he was able to simultaneously invest in building projects, animal husbandry, and even fish farming. The magnitude of payouts from these investments were so staggering that they shocked and bewildered Lucullus's contemporaries. With this extravagant wealth, Lucullus built the famed Gardens of Lucullus on the Mons Pincius, or Pincian Hill, which overlooked the Campus Martius. Lucullus also transformed his hereditary estate in the Alban Hills, or modern-day Tusculum, into a type of hotel-library complex, where scholars and philosophers could meet and share ideas. In addition to these, Lucullus lavishly patronized both the arts and sciences, earning himself the reputation as a standout philanthropist. In 75 BC, Nicomedes IV, the old king from whom Caesar had extracted a fleet of ships, died. Hoping to protect his people from being overrun by Mithridates of Pontus, Nicomedes bequeathed the entire kingdom of Bithynia to Rome. By making Bithynia Roman territory, Mithridates could no longer invade without the immediate risk of Roman retaliation. There would be no more sending envoys to the Senate in order to beg for assistance. Outraged by what Nicomedes had done, and confident since the death of Sulla, Mithridates declared war on Rome. Once again, the consular elections centered around a war against Mithridates. Because of his public recognition, his generosity in building public gardens, and the reputation he earned fighting alongside Sulla, Lucullus was elected to the 74 BC consulship alongside another Sullan supporter, and uncle of Caesar, Marcus Aurelius Cotta. Although Sulla's constitutional reforms required consuls and praetors to fulfill their terms within the city of Rome, the Senate was forced to overturn this stifling law. With Mithridates preparing for war, a full year could not be wasted. As Lucullus stayed in Rome to raise legions to take east, Caesar's uncle, Aurelius Cotta, was quickly sent ahead to Bithynia to begin her navigation from client kingdom to that of a proper Roman province. Anticipating some form of retaliation by Mithridates, Cotta immediately levied troops. Unfortunately, Mithridates invaded so fast that Cotta, with only half an army raised, had no choice but to withdraw to Chalcedon, or modern-day Cadidoi. From there, he sent urgent communications to Rome requesting support. Besides the need to help Cotta, disconcerting reports continued to flow from Hispania. Pompeius Magnus and Metellus Pius continued to flounder under Sertorius's hit-and-run attacks. In addition to their struggles against Sertorius and his allied Iberian and Lusitanian tribes, maintaining supplies for such a massive army became impossible. A spike in piracy had led to another severe disruption of maritime trade. This forced Pompeius and Metellus to split their armies so they could create better foraging opportunities. But, this also made both armies easier targets. To make matters worse, Marcus Perpurnavento, who had fled Sicily on the approach of Pompeius, had rejoined the Marian party under the attempts of Marcus Aemilius Lepidus. When Lepidus's rebellion failed, and he was forced to flee to Sardinia, Perpurna went with him. On Sardinia, upon the death of Lepidus, Perpurna took control of the legions. Heading to Hispania, he offered his legions, and himself to Quintus Sertorius. Making Perpurna his second in command, Sertorius was now able to pursue both Roman generals simultaneously. Sertorius marched his legions towards Metellus Pius, and Perpurna went after Pompeius Magnus. But Perpurna was hasty. When the armies fought, Pompeius Magnus regained some of his lost prestige by defeating Perpurna fairly quickly. Perpurna was saved by the arrival of Sertorius, whom Pompeius could not defeat. So, Frustrated and angry over the amount of his own personal wealth he had invested buying high-priced food and supplies for his army, Pompeius sat down and wrote a blistering letter to the Senate. Lucullus, as the only consul in Rome, would have read the letter out to the Senate, in which Pompeius swore that if the Senate did not come up with funds from the treasury with which to pay and feed his soldiers, he would simply march them back to Rome, and then the Senate could just deal with his angry and starving men themselves. Lucullus, however, did not seem to actually fear that Pompeius Magnus was threatening to march on Rome. Lucullus knew Pompeius. Pompeius had struggled to defeat Sertorius since arriving in Spain. So why threaten the Senate now, except if he was looking for an excuse to abandon the Sertorian War, which was neither lucrative nor as successful as Pompeius had imagined? Lucullus knew Pompeius had set his sights on the potential wealth and glory of bringing down Mithridates. But commanders, especially those who had strong-armed the Senate into granting him extra-legal proprietorial powers, did not just abandon one campaign in favor of another. And command of the war against Mithridates was the campaign on which Lucullus had run for election. He was not about to become the next Sulla, stripped of his command by a glory hound who was disappointed with his current war, yet outrageously popular enough with the people to manipulate himself into a new command. So Lucullus chose to become Pompeius's biggest champion within the Senate. He legislated, he pontificated, he debated and orated, and finally, the Senate approved the necessary funds from the state treasury to shut Pompeius up. As an additional boon, guaranteed to keep Pompeius in Spain, Lucullus also compelled the Senate into approving an additional levy of 2 more legions for Pompeius's use. In addition to resources for Cotta in the east, and Pompeius in Hispania, Lucullus was also forced to approve substantial state resources to the war the Senate had declared against piracy. To give him a better edge during his current war against Rome, Mithridates paid the pirate guilds in Cilicia to ensure maritime trade remained interrupted, so Rome's armies struggled to maintain fresh supplies. A newly elected praetor named Marcus Antonius, who was married to one of Caesar's cousins, was granted a bevy of broadly sweeping proprietorial powers, and charged with combating this enemy on the seas. 74 BC was an expensive year for the state treasury, but Lucullus, confident of victory over Mithridates, anticipated lavish riches from the east to replenish Rome's empty coffers. So, with the issues of legions for Spain, and resources for the pirates settled, Lucullus took on the war against Mithridates, for which he had raised legions of his own, and began moving his troops into Anatolia.